I'm Linda van Diepen. I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Ecosystem Science and Management at the University of Wyoming. I grew up in the Netherlands. My parents always had a vegetable garden, which I loved to work in. And at the time, I probably didn't know as much about what the soil microorganisms are actually doing and helping growing the vegetables in our garden. But I was definitely always interested in the environment, so I studied environmental science, and through my PhD research I really got interested in soil microbes. Microorganisms, as the word says, are essentially very small organisms that you cannot see with the naked eye, so bacteria, viruses, as well as fungi are part of that whole group of soil organisms. As part of a large EPSCoR grant that's called the Microbial Ecology Collaborative. There's now a lot more people at the University of Wyoming that are researching microbial ecology with a focus on the state of Wyoming. So in some ways, the research focuses on an exploration tour of Wyoming. So which microbes live within the state of Wyoming, in the soil, on the plants, every substrate possible. Part of some of the field research that we're doing is looking at the sagebrush. The sagebrush is basically the iconic plant that you can find in all the basins within Wyoming. Even though this sagebrush system is present in the basins, there's still a range of precipitation as well as temperature where that sagebrush plant can grow. So our interest is to see, are similar microorganisms associated with the sagebrush throughout that climate gradient, or do we find specific ones that are present more in the drier range of the sagebrush that might actually convey some drought tolerance? So to be able to predict and understand, will the sagebrush ecosystem be able to survive those changes in the climate based on the microorganisms that are present as related to precipitation as well as temperature. In agriculture settings, this would be important to get better yields or make plants more drought resistant, for example. Of course, we have our program in microbiology that look at more specific parts of the microorganisms, their physiology. If someone thinks microbial ecology, then a bell should go off thinking about the University of Wyoming.